The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitchagumi. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. Then later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The wind and the wires made a tattletale sound, and the wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind.
If you see the chappy that I'm going to pull here, trying to get to the aft here. Okay, here we go. Okay, now we can see, and that island on our starboard is
Monhegan.
You can see Monhegan over there. I haven't a clue if this thing is actually on or it's aimed in the right direction, but we'll give it a shot. So we're heading due east, as you can see, straight into the sunrise. Of course, it rose about 5 o'clock this morning. It was beautiful. I got some pictures of that. And that's the state of Maine there over on the left. And we saw some whales yesterday, one real large one and one probably a pilot whale. We saw some, what did we see, dolphins or what were those?
Well, we've seen dolphins, we've seen whales.
Yep.
We've seen sunfish.
Yep.
Haven't seen any great whites.
No, we saw some seals, right?
Seals, young and old.
Young and old. Who's that down below there? Is that the first mate?
That's Uncle Rick.
Uncle Rick. Hi, Uncle Rick. Uncle Rick's busy down there.
He's busy plotting a course to...
Plus he's got the diesel engine down there. Hey, right. Good morning, Uncle Rick. He's got the diesel engine down there, so it's kind of noisy. He can't hear a thing.
I'm deaf.
What? So the LNC Wells is 34 feet long?
Yep.
The beam is about what, 10 feet? 5, 8, 9 feet?
10 feet.
10 feet. She's a beautiful boat. And I can see here, you bought it from West Marine apparently, because it's got a West Marine sea cushions. Yeah. So anyways, it's as you can see, we're out here in the middle of the Atlantic. So okay. Well, good night. Wow. A Maine minefield, huh? On the lobster pots. Threading your way through them. another.
Look, get on the...
Yep, get on the port. Take the camera. How's she sailing, Captain?
Good.
4.5 knots. And that's pretty good with only a 1 knot wind. This is a beautiful sailing machine. Absolutely beautiful. Quiet too, a lot quieter than the diesel. Okay, Captain, what do you want?
I want you on that jib sheet. Yep, that's it.
Pull when you say so.
Just the four. Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Oh yeah, you gotta pull that in so we don't get a big slam. I gotta release this. Okay, alright, you ready?
Yep. Until it bangs, and then go with it.
How's that sheet on that traveler?
It's better.
Perfect. Get on course here.
Yep.
Looking.
It looks feels good.
You gotta go out at all?
No, it doesn't go out.
Huh?
No, it does not.
It does not.
Yeah,
okay.
It feels good.
Alright, you can
leave
that on.
Yep. Feels good.
I don't know if I'll
the legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald.